Well, the apple cider has been sitting in the carboys now for over 5 months to allow it to finish fermenting and then to allow all the solids to settle to the bottom of the container to make it a very clear liquid before bottling. So it's time to bottle. First thing you got to do is start by getting all your supplies together. And I like to keep my supplies in a bin that's labeled with, the contents on the outside so I can keep it all together. And then I use this star sand for sanitizing all the equipment. For this batch, I bought a couple cases of new bottles, and you start by washing the bottles, and then I just let them drip in the bottle tray. And at the same time, I sterilize the lids a little bit and everything else. For the bottles this time, I bought a sulfiter, I guess they call it, and it's just a little pump that allows you to sterilize the inside of the bottle very easily instead of trying to pour the sterilizer in and shake it out and everything else, which I'm really impressed with this little thing, and it just kind of squirts a hole inside of the bottle and it works real good. Now it's time to pull the airlock out of the first batch of cider, and then it's just a matter of siphoning everything off. And that time I made a mess because I just stuck the siphon in too fast. But just a matter of starting the siphon and siphoning it out into a bottling bucket and making sure that you leave about the bottom half inch or 3/4 of an inch of liquid in the carboy that contains all the dead yeast and all the everything that settled out of the batch of cider. Yeah, this batch had cleared up and it's nice and crystal clear now and ready to go. There you can see kind of what's laying in the bottom of the carboy that has settled out of the cider that you do not want to get into your bottling bucket. So when you get just about to the bottom, you want to make sure that you raise up the siphon and just turn it off. Then what I do is I just put the bucket up on a counter, and I put the little wand for bottling in it, and I put a plastic container on the bottom to catch any drips, because if they do drip into carpet, it'll smell like hard cider for months. And then it's just a matter of holding each of the sanitized bottles up on the bottling wand, and there's a little valve on the bottom of it that turns the flow of the cider on when you push the bottle up. And then when the bottle is just about full, you let the bottle down a little bit and it shuts the flow off, and it's ready to move on and do the next bottle. Yeah, this is a about the most boring job of the bottling, because it takes some time to fill up a 22-ounce bottle. And let's see, I'm planning on getting about 28 of them out of each 5-gallon container. So you can imagine just how long it takes. And the most important part of this step is just to make sure that all the equipment has been properly washed and sterilized before you start any bottling whatsoever. And just try to kind of keep everything clean while you're going along. With the bottles all full and just a drop left in the container, I guess that means that I get the last little sip out of the bottom to do a taste test and quality control test. Turns out it's really a good batch again. It just doesn't quite have the flavor that some of my other previous batches have had, but the apples that I started with last fall did not have the same flavor either. But all in all, I'm happy with the results. Then the next thing to do is to put the bottle caps on. I like to just kind of drop the caps on each bottle and then go back. I've got this little plastic bottle capper that just squeezes down on the bottle. It catches on the top lip of the bottle and it pulls a plate down that seals the bottle caps. I like to go down and do it once, and then I'll turn the bottle 90 degrees and I'll just hit it again just to be sure that I've got a good seal and I didn't mess something up. And this goes pretty quick. It's just a couple minute job to get them all done. And here's the first batch all sealed up. I got 22-ounce bottles out of that 5-gallon carboy. Now it's time to go on to the next 5-gallon batch. And basically, it's the exact same procedure that I just went through for the first carboy full. And it's a matter of making sure that everything is cleaned, washed, and sanitized, just so you don't get any contamination that could cause off tastes and problems later. And as you can see, this carboy is extremely well cleared up too. And the cork's sticking a little bit, but it'll come out eventually. And then it's just a matter of going through the whole siphoning procedure to siphon the clear liquid off of what's left in the bottom laying there, the dregs or whatever they call it. This time I was a little bit more careful with the siphon, and I did not spill any. So I made sure to pull the siphon up as I was going down into the container. And it's just a matter of siphoning everything into the bottling bucket again and getting ready to repeat the whole procedure. You just have to remember not to stir any of the stuff up on the bottom when you are siphoning it off. And here we go. We go back into the bottling mode again. And this one I'm using the 22-ounce bottles again for. They seem to be a good size to share a bottle of cider with someone. And that size bottle seems to allow me to store a lot more in my beer refrigerator or beer/cider refrigerator because they seem to take up less space. They're a little bit taller, but they're not much wider than the 12-ounce bottles. And here we go again. We're just filling the next batch of bottles up. And we're going to go through this for another 28 bottles. And then it's back to the capping. And like I said, I like to just kind of lay the caps on the bottle before I start. It seems to be easier with my capper. There is a magnet up in it that you can put the cap on and try to do that, but I've had problems where it actually turns sideways and slips off the magnet if you don't lay it flat to start out. So that's kind of the way that I do it with all these neck bottles, I guess, that you call them, that you use caps on. So a short while later, I have another 28 bottles, and I actually use different color caps on the different bottles so I can distinguish what batch they're from before I put labels on them. Then for the third batch, I have a bunch of bottles that that use a rubber seal on them. They have a flip bail type thing, and I like to every year when I reuse them, I like to just pop off the old rubber seals, and for whatever it costs, 7 or 8 cents it costs for the new seals, I just buy a batch and I replace them all just to be safe. I think that you can use them for several years, but I really don't know, and I really don't want to ruin a bottle of cider over a couple cent seal. And then it's just a matter of the same procedure for the third batch. You wash the bottles, then you go back and you sulfate the bottles to make sure that there's no bacteria or anything growing in them. And as I said before, I replace the seal on all these type bottles. With the clear bottle here, you can get a pretty good idea of how that sulfator works. And it does a really great job of evenly distributing all the sanitizing solution inside the bottle to make sure it's really good and ready to bottle. Same thing here. I went through and I had to wash and then sanitize all the equipment again before starting this next batch. And it's just a matter of siphoning the clear liquid out of the top of the carboy into the bottling bucket again. And this one was only a 3-gallon carboy, so this whole setup will go quite a bit quicker, and it's going to yield a lot less than the other two 5 gallons did. It's just amazing now when I taste each of these batches. Each of the three batch has quite a distinct flavor. Just by modifying the amount of white sugar, the amount of brown sugar, and the type of yeast gives you a totally different flavor and also a totally different alcohol content. And the one thing that I found is don't be afraid to experiment with different combinations and different sugars and different yeasts, because each one yields such a different flavor. And I have not yet made one that was actually awful to drink. They all seem to come out pretty good, but they're all a little bit different. Well, after about 5 hours of work, most of it was spent washing and cleaning and sanitizing items. This was the results, and this is the hard cider that I have to enjoy this year throughout the summer. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.